Well, the main point is that there are political turf battles. That's the main point. I don't think we should beat around the bush today. Mr. Subramaniam, Mr. Subramaniam, is it or not simply about political turf battles? That is the reason why you don't have an NCTC.
Arnab, you are perfectly correct. Yeah. It is extremely important, apart from the policy issue I referred to, extremely important to strengthen the institutions, strengthen the procedures. And NCTC could potentially be one such agency. But take just half a minute to understand the implications. I have seen closely the implementation of POTA, of COFAPUSA. Both these had tremendous objectives. Ultimately, they were used as weapons to subjugate people people to heel at various places. What I'm saying is, it's dangerous to have an intelligence agency and an action agency linked together. You must segregate the intelligence agency from the action agency, number one. Number two, our experience has been that the IB and the CBI, which are technical agencies, are not used so much for technical purposes, but for inter-say party activities by whoever is in power. Now, there is a great danger. If you meet these two with sufficient safeguards, and mechanism like NCTC is extremely important, extremely useful. Otherwise, it can be a major weapon in the hands of whoever is in power.
Well, I mean, that basically is means to say India will never have a centralized counter-terror mechanism. Mahesh Jethpalani. So we'll come back to square one. There will be another series of blasts. We will keep sitting and discussing this, but there will never be a centralized counter-terror mechanism because there is a feud between state governments and central government. State governments feel their powers are going to be encroached upon.
NCTC will not preempt.
Well,
NCTC will not stop terror attacks alone. There has to be political will.
No, but where is the political will to have an NCTC if America have a centralized counter-terror structure?
Arnab, another one aspect.
I want to get Mahesh Jethpalani. If America can have a centralized counter-terror center where a person can go from Memphis to Detroit to Louisiana and go there and crack any terror case without going through red tape and wasting time, Mahesh Jethpalani, you know that this is most critical. However, you know, your party is also simply currying favor with other parties and regional parties who want to keep this issue afloat politically because they don't want to give up their local jurisdictions. So the fight against terror, Mahesh Jethpalani, boils down to politics also for you, I'm afraid. It boils down to politics as much as it boils down to inaction for the central government.
Arnav, I'm going to let that personal barb pass. I think you inject more politics into debates than anybody else does. There's a very simple situation. Today you have the NIA, which is a federal police force, which is empowered to go. You must know that the National
Investigating Agency Act was passed unanimously. Which your party described as a half measure.
But that's the half. I have already answered that question. I'm not going to repeat it just where you get a debating point.
Well,
I've already answered that question.
Pointing something to you.
The half measure we talked about is you must, the remaining part is that you must have the political will. Having a plethora of laws centralized or decentralized is not the answer.
No, you say political will, but you will not allow a body. You will not allow a body to be put together. A body which can prove to be tremendously successful. Globally, let me tell you why it would change things here. If a centralized counter-terror center would be there, then your Mumbai police... Mahesh Jethpalani, 1 minute. Now, I'm not making any bars. I'm making a factual point to you. If an NCTC were to be there...
You are asking a question which if you have the answer, you shouldn't ask the question.
I am asking you a counter question. Don't get worked up.
Counter question to your own question.
I am asking a counter question to your point, if you allow me.
I don't understand this.
Let me ask you. Do you disagree? However uncomfortable it is, answer my question. Do you disagree that if an NCTC were to be there...
Nothing is uncomfortable. I'm willing to answer all questions. I'm not in power today.
So the question is this, do you disagree... Do you disagree that if an NCTC were to be there, that the information that was there with the Mumbai police, that three people went underground, coupled with the information of what the Tihar police convict in that case spoke about the recce of Dilsukh Nagar, would have been passed coterminously to the Hyderabad police for actionable intelligence, action on the ground, and we would not be sitting here discussing why this incident happened in Dilsukh Nagar? It's as simple as that.
But Arnav,
it's as simple as
that. I'm asked, there's a very simple answer to that. Now, please let me answer you. There's a very simple answer. You already have a federal police force. The National Investigating Agency has all India jurisdiction. It was passed unanimously.
It has had a terrible track
today
record.
The NIA can go into any state. But that's a terrible track record. So what makes you so sure you have an NCTC? It's going to have a better track record. You want to have you use past examples and you forget them.
You say, okay, well, anyway, this is not just
between. And then you want to repeat the same mistake and you assume that the next police organization, just because you give it a different nomenclature, will be more efficient.
I am only talking, you're getting unnecessarily worked up. I'm simply talking about the flow of information. I am simply talking about the flow of information and how it would have been eased up. You may have trouble with it becoming too powerful a body. That is the point, Swaranjit Sen, isn't it?
Yeah.
The real problem with the NCTC is that some people believe it will become too powerful a body.
No, not at all. And I think NCTC is certainly required. And if you don't have it, there will not be the required cohesion. That is the fact on ground. Now, if the NCTC is going to help in preempting offences like this, terrorism acts like this, why not? Why should we be so shy about, just because there is an NIA, but usually the NIA comes into action post the offence of Terrorism Act, an investigation agency. We are talking about an agency which could combine all the information and make the states feel the importance of acting. Now that is what we are talking about. And this matter has been discussed in great detail. I was part of the Commission on Center-State Relations and we strongly recommended this. I don't think that there's any reason why anyone should go against
and
it.
And we forget what
it's
we said. We forget
more
what
to
we
coordinate affairs.
No, what is it, Mr. Anjan?
Your recommendation do not hold the ground.
What?
The government of India is not interested to have this center-state relation, you see, recommendation. They are not worried about the police recommendation. They are not, interested about the many times the decision, all party decision which has taken place inside the parliament. The main question today, if we see what the Home Minister's statement says, that the same police type of a statement, if somewhere something goes on, there's a permanent phrase.
I think situation we don't learn from our experiences.
Situation
Mr. Anjan,
under
we are
control,
not, we don't learn from
but
our
the situation
experiences.
Is tense, but under control.
No, the problem is, Mr. Anjan, I go to Rana Bhai, we don't learn from our experiences. NCTC was conceived after 2611.
That's true.
People like Mahesh Jethmalani, when people like Mahesh Jethmalani and others came out and said, let's have a strong state, let's sift through the intelligence provided by different agencies. Let's give an agency, let's create an agency which will have the power to carry out searches and arrests without any bureaucracy in any part of information of India to collect, collate and disseminate data on terrorism and decide what should be acted on. That is precisely what people like Mahesh Jethmalani said in 2008 after 2611. However, today, politics crept in for 4.5 years. I've said right at the start, and Renuka Chaudhary got upset. I did say that the center did not act like it should have. But if an NCTC was there, then perhaps we would have had some teeth to act. Am I completely wrong in that, Rana Banerjee, on the NCTC point? Rana Banerjee, please.
No, absolutely right.
Rana Banerjee, please.
Right. Regarding the NCTC.
Right about that.
Yeah, Rana Banerjee.
Regarding the NCTC, the main problem has been of getting it to have police powers. Now, as long as policing is a state subject, all the state governments have resisted handing over of any police powers to the NCTC for taking up preemptive operations. This has been the main problem. And to get around that, you have to have a via media where you co-opt state police officials into the NCTC or mechanism, whatever, from the center to take on joint operations. But the argument against that is that it jeopardizes the secrecy of such operations.
And that's
now, the other point that I'd like to make is about the Indian Mujahideen. Now they have become much more sophisticated and their footprint is very much inside India, although there is no denying that initially the Pakistanis, fostered and fomented it just to create an institution or a set of people whom they could distance themselves from. But now the modules are on the ground and the modules are very active in Pune, in Bhatkal, in Darbhanga, Azamgarh, and all of them have people who then gravitate onto places like Hyderabad. So you have to have the state police ability to catch the movements of these people on their own. So these are the two points that I like to
make. No, absolutely, I agree with you. But you know, yes, Mahesh Jethwalani, you I don't think you have any fresh position. You know, you have taken a hard position on the NCTC. But yes, please go ahead.
First of all, I never spoke in favor of the NCTC in 2008.
You spoke in favor of everything that the NCTC represents.
No, I did not. In fact, I have a petition challenging even the NIA, the jurisdiction of the NIA pending in the Bombay High Court. I have been against it because in actual practice, what happens is these federal agencies like the CBI will be misused. I find that the state polices are much, much more effective. And please let me tell you something. Let us take the you are now extrapolating from the present incident to recommending the need for the NCTC, the present incident in Hyderabad. What is the failure over there which calls for the NCTC?
You the failure had of the Delhi police. The failure of the dissemination and action of information.
But why do you need the NCTC? All they had to do was convey this to the Hyderabad police. The Delhi police conveyed it to the Hyderabad police. Is that not happened? Don't you have interstate cooperation? If I had information that a crime is about, if Maharashtra police have information that a crime is about to be committed in another state, elementary common police prudence would demand
that in India, unless you institutionalize something, it is not done. I'll take the counter view from Renuka Chaudhary. Renuka Chaudhary, Mahesh Jethwalani says this does not prove any need for NCTC. There can be interstate cooperation on intelligence sharing without any formalized structure. Your response to that, please.
I think with changing times, we need changing instruments. We can say there are enough laws on every subject, Arnav. There were enough laws on women's safety and security. What happened? So it's not, why are we resistant to change? Why are we resistant to take a step that will bring more cohesiveness? Why do we start everything with a suspicion? What is wrong with NCTC? If you will have accountability of one agency, then you can't have state government saying we didn't know, we didn't do or whatever. Why is it that we don't want to give that accountability?
How come the same argument of yours did not apply? I have a counter question to Renuka Chaudhary. Already one hand goes up. I let Mahesh Jethwalani counter first. Dhawa, I'll place my question to Renuka Chaudhary on record. How come this was not the position of the Congress party when the NDA was pushing for POTA? At that time, the NDA said that extraordinary times call for extraordinary measures and the Congress party, you know, always looked the other way on that. I'll get an answer later, but I'll couple that with Mahesh Jethwalani's counter.
Because we were a little alarmed at the NDA's lack of experience.
You are alarmed at the NDA's lack of experience then? Okay, Mahesh Jethwalani.
No, we gave a ministerial escort. Don't forget that. We gave ministerial escort. At that point, when Parliament was under attack, Congress came and said, hands down, go ahead and do what you have to do. We will support you. It was us who said that.
Yes, Mr. Jethwalani.
And then we saw unraveling in front of our eyes where they were given a ministerial escort to go. And they were escorted in an aircraft with a minister taking them specially. And then these terrorists came back and targeted India.
Yes, Mr. Jethwalani. Last counter from Mr. Jethwalani to the Congress.
We said that doesn't mean that this is the way to do it now. Are we ready for a national mechanism
or not? Arnav, let me quickly answer. Renuka has been going on. Let me just answer three quick questions. First of all, POTA was not for creation of a new police agency, either an intelligence one or an investigating one. POTA was for strengthening laws by making confessions admissible and changing bail terms, changing grant of bail and remand to custody. That was predominantly what POTA was about. It had nothing to do with the creation of a new intelligence agency. Secondly, as far as Kandahar is concerned, I might tell Renuka Chaudhary immediately, who wants to score petty debating points, that Manmohan Singh led a delegation to the Prime Minister and he said that the prime concern of this government should be the safety of the hijack passengers. This is on record. Please read your newspapers. And by the way, Sonia Gandhi wasn't in India at that time. She made no contribution. Thirdly, Arnav, we have the experience of the NIA. We have the experience of the NIA, which was an investigating agency, albeit not. It was not an intelligence agency. The NIA has been grossly misused by the government at the center, just like the CBI has. All it has been used to do is to put political opponents into embarrassing positions, foment cases against them. The CBI does the same thing. The NIA is politicizing terror, and I have no doubt that if you have a NCTC, all the intelligence gathering they will do is tapping the private phones.
No, but it appears to me that there is a deep suspicion between different parts of the political class. But because of that, you see, the people cannot suffer. Create an agency, depoliticize it, speed up actioning, and spare repeated attacks, and find a solution as soon as you can.
And get accountability.
Well, accountability also, action, accountability, and ask the Delhi police why they didn't act for so long. Renuka Chaudhary, you know, I'm very short of time, but on the other side, as I thank all my panelists.
Our judicial system, a transparent judicial system, our laws are quite efficient, our CRPC and IPC are quite powerful. The question is this,
how many politicians have gone there and scored brownie points, with those who are suspected in terror activities. We also have to be careful of that, and we have to draw the line there as well. And that also happens across the political spectrum. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get together. Let's create something cohesive. And let's not be seen to be a sitting duck for terror attacks. Thank you very much for debate number one.
But at one point, in the name of fighting terrorism, innocent people cannot be put behind the bar.
That point is understood. That point is understood. But innocent people are also dying. And my limited point is about the innocent people who are dying, not just about the innocent people who you think will be targeted, Mr. Anjan. Thank you very much for joining me on debate number one on the News Hour tonight.